Hello Taurians, welcome to my channel Surabhi, and in this video we'll be seeing what your person is thinking about you, what are their feelings for you, and what is the obstacle which is coming, if there is any, to reach you or to come to you, and what are they planning, what is their next action, what are they planning to do. Okay, so Taurians, I'll be taking one card each for this deck and then clarifying with the other deck. So let's see what is the feeling of the person Taurus is thinking about. So for the feelings, we have the Seven of Wands. Okay. Is there any obstacle? What is the obstacle in this relationship to move forward? Okay, so obstacle, we have the Eight of Swords. So for the feelings, we have the Seven of Wands. Okay, so what are they thinking of doing? What is their next move? What are they planning to do? Do they want to act or they don't want to act? What are they planning to do? What are they thinking of doing? Okay, wow, that is beautiful, the Four of Wands. Okay, so for their feelings, we have the Seven of Wands. So I think either this person is struggling with something or they are trying to defend something. So there is something in their life, perhaps with you or with the, in general, that this person is defensive. In some way, shape or form, this person is defensive. We'll see what are the clarifiers. Why is this person struggling with something? Why are they being so defensive? Okay, what has happened here? Why is this person feeling defensive towards you? Why is this Seven of Wands? So for the Seven of Wands, we have the Wheel of Fortune, the Nine of Pentacles, and the King of Swords. Okay, so what I feel here is that this person is behaving in a little cold and a detached way. They are struggling with something within themselves. Okay, they are struggling with something within themselves. They need to heal. With the Nine of Pentacles, they need some time. They need to focus on their self-worth. They need to focus on their own. They just need time to heal. Okay, so with the Ten of Wheels, what I feel is something has happened in their life in the past with you, or in general some other aspect of their life, not necessarily a previous relationship only, it can be anything else in their life. But the thing is, since they are meeting you or they are in a relationship with you, something has changed. With the Ten of Wheels, something has changed. Maybe meeting you itself was a big change in their life. Some major change has happened in the life, what I feel. And this person is, because of that reason, some change has come up. Maybe it is a transient situation in their life. Maybe dealing with something. Maybe they have some other issues in their life which they are dealing with. Something has changed. Maybe this person was very, very romantic initially with you, and now you are feeling that they are behaving in a distant way. It can be that also for some of you, and you are just wondering as to why this person is behaving like this. So maybe they are dealing with something in their life. Okay, and because of that, maybe they are not showing that to you, and that is why they are being defensive. Okay, maybe they just don't want to bother you. It can be as simple as that. We'll see what the clarifiers are for the others who other cards. But yes, this person, whatever this person is doing, is behaving in a little cold and a detached way. It's because they're struggling with something in their life and they are focusing on themselves. They are just healing. They're coming out of something. Just give them that time. Okay, and here as the obstacles, we have the Eight of Swords. So something is definitely there in their life that this person is finding it hard to move towards you. And I think that is what they are struggling with. They are struggling with some experiences in the past, or maybe in the current situation, something is actually holding them back. It is very tough for this person to let go of something of the past or the past experiences and step out. It's not that they can't, but they are so scared because they don't want to hurt themselves. They don't want any emotional emotional trauma once again in their life. And that is why this is the obstacle which is coming in their path to move towards you. Okay. Let's see what is this Eight of Swords about. What is this Eight of Swords about? So for the Eight of Swords, we have the Magician, the Fool, beautiful, and the Sun. What else would you want, Taurians? See, all three major cards are there, Magician, Fool, and the Sun. So definitely, this person is struggling to come out of whatever is holding them back. They just need some time to heal. Just give them the time and just see. We have beautiful new beginnings, and that is what they, though there is a, this is an obstacle, but they are struggling to come out of it, and they will come out of it. And that is why here, as the most likely outcome in the near future, that is what they are planning to do with the Four of Wands. This is the commitment. This is a relationship. So that is what they are planning to do. They are fighting their inner fears. They are fighting whatever they are dealing with. They want to come out of it. And with the Magician, the Fool, definitely they will come out of it. Taking the leap of faith, manifesting new beginnings with you, and with the Sun card, it is a beautiful, beautiful relationship which is going to give you a lot of happiness. Okay, it is something really beautiful, Taurians. Let's see, what are they planning to do in the near future is the Four of Wands. So they want a commitment. They want to commit to you. Okay, that is what they are seeking. Okay, and for that we have the Page of Pentacles, the Queen of Swords, and the King of Cups. So here you see similar reading, similar these two cards were there in the Aries reading also. Maybe you are dealing with an Aries. Okay, so here what I feel is that they are wanting a commitment from you. They want a commitment, so they will step up, but in a very small way. Okay, because it, though they have fought their negatives, they have fought whatever it was holding them back. This is what they are planning to do. They want this, they want to come out of it, and they will succeed in coming out of it. They will be able to remove this obstacle, but the step which they will take will be a small one. Okay, they will not move into it or in a very fast way. They won't rush into it. They will just give you an inclination or a small step forward. With the Queen of Swords and the King of Cups, they may have a lot of emotions, but they will not show you that much. Okay, they will just give a small hint, I should say, or a clue, or a small step will be taken for this commitment. Okay, maybe just to see what you reply, maybe what your reaction is, how will you behave, because they don't want to be rejected. Perhaps this is the fear which is holding them back already. Okay, maybe it is just the fear of rejection which is holding them back. But yes, they do want to have a new beginning with you. They will do it, but yes, they will not rush into you. They will not just come and surprise you with lovey-dovey gifts. And it may not be a very huge deal. Okay, this is how I'm going to commit, and that fairy tale type of romance, it may not be there. But yes, it can be a very small step forward. You just need to be vigilant and understand, because this person has already dealt with something in the past. They will not want to be hurt again. So you just have to be understanding for that aspect, that it may not be that lavish, it may not be that extravagant, it may not be that I should say fairy tale. As I said, it can be a very simple gesture, but you should have to respect that and give whatever you feel is the reply you want to give to them. So Taurians, that's all I have for you. Hope it helps, and please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Let's meet in the next video. Bye.